Brooklyn. Welcome to the big leagues, bro. This is how I do it. Treat me fine, but my homies all think that I'm losing my mind. I'm tripping and I know it, cause I'm all nerved up. Cause every time I go to sleep, I see this big old butt. See, I ain't never gave no chick four stars, but she treat me so good that she be driving my car. And every day it get better, I can't lie. Went to a house that she made me some hot potato pie. All my friends be saying she ain't nothing but a scrub, but she makes me feel high like I'm hooked on drugs. So I give her what she need, and what's done is done. I'm a special kind of fool, but ayo, it don't bore me none. I can't help myself, I know that I'm tripping, but she got it going on like Kentucky Fried Chicken. So
every time find them big boys, they can handle them.
Okay.
They be alright. They be alright. They'll get the next guy. I'm not totally in disagreement with Boo about fighting.
Okay. You know
what I mean? But with that said, you know what I mean? You know, the Nike shit is, it is what it is. They've been in the business longer than everybody else.
That's what
so
I
they
said.
Understand it. 1999, I'm a student at Hampton University. The Boo Williams tournament is there. I'm working the tournament. I'm watching DeWine Wagner kill every freaking guard in the country at Boo Williams. Guys older than him, Omar Cook and all those guys. I see Tyson Chandler, Eddie Curry for the first time. So I know the Nike stuff. I used to go to Nike Super Showcase every year. I seen Kyrie Irving destroy Team Final. Destroy by himself. It was him by himself against Michael Gilchrist, Deion Waiters, and all the rest of them. And he had 45 points with Coach K and what's his name sitting right there in front, Nate James sitting right there front center. I seen the whole thing, and this was 10 years ago. I was there. I know what Nike do. I know how they do it.
So if everybody, see, this is what's confusing. Everybody is saying the same thing I'm saying. If I'm saying this, if we all saying the same thing about how am I the bad guy?
Because
how?
Nobody,
how we all here?
No, nobody's saying you're the bad guy, but people would take the narrative you created and run with it. And I told
when
you, I told him this
when
before.
When I said it's dangerous, people, it's irresponsible.
What I call you and say, somebody said, Boo said, we are one of Under Armour. It ain't even close. If I was a kid, I played for.
I called you and told you that. Though.
You said the person they know I knew you.
Like, right? They called me. It was like Boo said. I was like, yeah. He said what?
I text Boo. I said, yo, they coming. You got no idea.
I heard you. And when he went on his drone, it was your post about Coach Greg, right? About He would have been grandfathered in if he didn't do whatever right. He did, whatever. And then I was seeing all these tags. I'm like, what? So it caught me off guard because I didn't have nothing to do with the post, and I didn't even know what the
now,
angle.
Now I'm gonna speak for him real quick. When he said peanut gallery, that wasn't just for you.
He said I was the commissioner or some shit like that.
Your page is the gallery. Your page is the no holds barred.
Angelo Pataldi is the grandmaster of peanut gallery. Yes. And he make $1.5 million a year.
Yes.
He the grandmaster of the cheap seats. He the grandmaster of that shit. And he make $1.5 million a year. Skip Bayless makes more than that. And he,
well, you know.
But it depends on by me not being involved in that post makes it like a reach. You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's what
and that's I'm like, what?
And that's what he acknowledged.
I ain't even on his drawing. Like,
he acknowledged that.
No, but if he would have came on my post on when I said that and said, then that would have been a whole different story. Or he could have. Everybody got my number. He could have reached out. Kamal called me when he was walking on the airplane.
Welcome to the big leagues, bro. This is how I do it.
Like, boom. I'm walking in a prayer. We gonna talk.
But you know what's impressive though, Boo? Seriously, you know what's impressive? Y'all sitting here, y'all speaking. Boo, I have walked up to gym doors. Seriously, and had security say, "Coach, don't want you in the gym."
You too dangerous,
dude. It's like that. Like I'm carrying,
but that's a
Uzi or something, man. But it can get bad. So we're doing better, man.
But that's how it is in the city. That's how it is, like. It looked deeper. All it is a conversation. That's all it is.
And I'm glad we had.
That's all it is. If he would have reached out to me like he tagged me, this wouldn't even went as far as it went. But
Boo, last time I seen you, I was teasing you about being in Del Sandro. So you
that was the last time I seen you.
I said I thought you losing weight.
And I did lose weight. And I wasn't even getting a sandwich for me.
No, Rodney was getting one, but still.
Yeah.
You put that video up with your boy OT. I was like, Boo,
you lost
a lot of weight.
Help myself, I know that I'm tripping, but she got it going on like Kentucky Fried Chicken. times she asked me for my credit card. You know she get it cause she know that.
Chill, see?
I know she. I used to be the player, now I'm getting pimped. I used to be hard, now I'm living all limp. Why I let her play me? You can't understand. So sit yourself down and just listen to my man.